the witness you all and the so many people who are responding to the fact that we are using our cell phones during our time of prayer. And I'm so grateful that how God has used this small gesture to help so many people throughout our faith community, as well as other people that you know. And I didn't realize how much of an impact that it would have for people like Cordell and Bernice Reed, who are able to hear. And Cordell has gone through a whole lot, as others have physically. But yet when on Sunday he anticipates now of getting the phone call and to hear the prayers and to hear the noise or the response from the congregation, I've witnessed it after services, how his whole day is so different. And then it helps Bernice, because when you're there and you feel like you're all alone, come on somebody. If you've never been a caregiver of your loved one, of your family member or friend, when everybody else can still get up and get around and you feel like you are stuck, I thank God not for the necessarily for giving me trials or tribulations, but I thank God for them. Hear me, y'all. Because they have helped me to be sensitive and compassionate when I hear others. And I don't just pray, but I literally pray for you. When I think about how we, in the middle of the night, if we needed to get up to get a glass of water, to go to the restroom, hear me, y'all. You can make a decision to sit there or lie there, or you can get up. There's some people who desire to get up and they can't get up unless somebody is there. My mom can't get up. Can you imagine? So one day I was thinking about that for myself, and I said, right now, if I want to get up, I can get up. And I don't have to wait on nobody to take my legs and pull them over and sit them out and get somebody to put my torso up. I can just get up. There are people in our faith community who can't. I live with it. I experience it. And yet, I see God's mercies. I see God's continued grace. So when we are here for intercessory prayer, it's not form. It's not for fashion. We're really interceding on behalf of others. Because see, you don't know what it took. The person, dog, I see you back there. You don't know what it takes for people to get here. And all the things they have to go through to prepare just to get here. And then when they sit in their seat, they can exhale and say, okay, God, give me the strength to face what I need to face. Yours may not be physical. It may be mental. Yours may not be mental. It may be financial. Yours may not be financial or mental. It may be other things. That's why right now is the only moment that we have. And I'm while you have a chance, clap. While you have a chance, raise your hand. While you have a chance, you can stand up to your own 2 feet. You ought to use what God has given you while you have the chance. Don't you take it for granted that every day is going to be like today. Thank God for the right now moment. I don't want to hear the pastor say, lift my hand. I don't want nobody to tell me. But you would wish you were able to lift your hands if you're flat on your bed. So I've learned, young people, you ain't got to tell me to praise him. When I think of the goodness of God And we want to become a culture that nobody got to pump you up. We want to be a faith community that nobody's got to come and run around circles and jump up and down and swing from the chandeliers. You ought to have enough thankfulness in your own heart that every now and then a tear ought to come down one of your cheeks. Every now and then your hand ought to be lifted up. Every now and then you ought to lift up your head and tell the Lord with an open voice, thank you. How many of you know that God will give us encouragers in the house? I look around this room and I see encouragers. Because I see what you've been through and how you come, how God has brought you out. I'm encouraged. Are you with me? I can look all, I don't want to start calling names, but I can look all around this room and see how, what God, and who am I to sit back and start complaining? I can't. That's why I know that y'all ain't playing because y'all here today. Y'all ain't playing. You came to worship God. It ain't no tradition. This ain't no good luck to come here on first Sunday. I came because every day is a good day. I came because the Lord is good to me every day. He's my Savior. He's my rock. He's my Redeemer. I owe Him every day. I owe Him the best praise I can. I owe Him. I owe Him the best praise I can give Him. I owe Him. And if you haven't got to a life experience where you ain't, where you bold enough, I'm bold enough to give Him any praise anywhere, anyhow. Because He's just so good. And I'm glad to be standing here in my good health, in my right mind. So I want y'all to join me in prayer. Every day is a day of thanksgiving. God's been so good to me. The altar is open. Every day. Sing it, choir.
Take the time to
matter how hard it's been, those of you who are listening by phone, it's our prayer time. Those of you who are on the phone, it's time for us to pray one for another. We're going to pray for you. We're gathered around the altar and some are standing in the pew. But we're just singing this song, you all, because he is blessing us over and over again. It's rough, but guess what? He's blessed you to have the strength to get through it. Amen. He keeps blessing me. You ought to confess that for yourself. He's blessing me. Ah, yes, he is. He opens the doors that I cannot see. He's blessing me. Confess that. He keeps blessing me. We're praying for those who are connected with us. We're praying for those who are connected with us on the phone. Our Father, and you are our God. We pause right now to thank you. In the midst of it all, and even in spite of it all, we want to say thank you, Lord. And we come on this day, God, asking in the name of Jesus that you will continue to be our guide, direct our path, empower us, O God, through the working of the Holy Spirit. You know what we stand in need of. You know our heart's desire. God, you even know our shortcomings. Thank you for forgiving us. Thank you for restoring us. Thank you for walking with us. Thank you for providing for us. Thank you for looking out for all of us. Even when we didn't know how to look out for ourselves, we want to say thank you. And God, today, not only do we pray for ourselves, but God, we pray for those who are on our prayer list today. God, touch Georgette right now. Touch her body right now in the name of Jesus. Give her this physical strength that she needs. God, we lift up Sister Pearson, oh God, Pam's mom. And God, these others who are on the prayer line right now, those who are on the phone, we are praying for them individually and collectively. God, is a new beginning. And God, we're touching and agreeing because old things have passed away. And God, today is a new beginning, new attitude, a new trust, a new belief, oh God. We're thanking you, Lord. So God, these persons, Cordell, we speak life into you. Bernice, we speak joy into you. We speak peace of mind. To everybody who's on the phone right now, I speak life. It shall not carry you out. It's going to lift you up. It should now bring you down. It's going to lift you up. So God, we pray and continue to lift up Willie Mae Cook. Dorcas, we're continuing to believe in God for your strength. You're in the sanctuary. We're believing God to give you the strength. You are an overcomer because you've been empowered. Mary Turner, Adrian, it's not going to be the same. It's going to be a new year, baby. Get your attitude right. Get your walk right. You're getting ready to walk into greatness. You're getting ready to walk into your blessing. We thank you in advance for the manifestation of Dolores. We thank you for Evelyn. We thank you for Donald. He shall recover. Samantha, all is well. William, peace in your mind, in the name of Jesus. Mitch, we speak peace to your body and to your mind. Coley, we speak peace to your body and to your mind. David, we speak peace to your body and to your mind. Christine, we speak love. Johnny, hope to those members in the Alden Nursing Home. And to every member of the sound of my voice, I speak life. You shall not die, but you shall live to declare the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bury the past. We bury our faults. And we raise today a new beginning, a new understanding, a new opportunity in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I speak life to you. I speak hope to you. You are empowered to face it. And God, right now, we thank you for the baptism of the Holy Spirit that's falling fresh on this place. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Oh God, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. God, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Pour out yourself. God, and for members who are at home right now, for health reasons, members who are at home because of misunderstanding with other members, members who are at home because they're angry, they didn't like what was said here or there, God, I pray that you would put them in a right relationship with you. And God, you know who I'm talking about, so I won't call the names, but God, touch them right now. Touch their spouses, and God, touch us who have offended people. Forgive us for the offense, the wrong attitude, the wrong statement, so that our witness will be to your glory. So now, God, baptize us. Baptize us once more and again, so that whatever we have to face in 2017, we're going to face it with joy. We're going to face it with a thankful heart. We're going to face it, oh God, with faith. We're going to face it with trust, because we already know that your hand is in it, oh God. And you're going to bring us out victorious. So God, we wave our hands back to glory and say thank you for taking care of us. Thank you for making it all well. And we believe it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, put those hands together and give the Lord a praise offering. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, show some love. Show some love. It's already done. God bless you. God bless those who were hooked up with us. Praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Whatever is to come, God will give you the ability to face it. He will give you the strength to face it. Whatever is to come, watch him do it, y'all. Watch him do it. In Jesus' name, it is. So God bless this word and make it a blessing to all. in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Amen. I'm not going to be able to give you all of the New Year's Day sermon. We're going to be doing it in parts. Boy, Felicia, your best is coming. Yeah, it is. No, for real, it really, 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 really is. It is so there. In fact, you on the delivery table right now. If you can just imagine yourself right now, you've been there. I just want you to push through the pain. Push. Do you hear me? Your best. He's setting. In fact, all of this, for those of you who don't understand, if you were to come to Bible class, I'm in a little different space right now. So just be patient with me. But Felicia, you thought all this was to tear you down? Mm-mm. God has used all of this, all these years, to get you, and I'm talking to somebody else too, to get you just where He wanted you. Help us in Jesus' name. I can look around this room and the message is really for everyone. But some of you are pulling at me and I feel your pull in the spirit. And you're wondering, is it really, or are you just giving us some good New Year's Day cliche? I'm not into theme writing and cliches for the new year, but I believe with all of my heart that God is going to set us up. Amen. In fact, not going to, Sean, but He has used all of what we have experienced in our lives to this very moment. Don't get hooked up because I'm calling out a certain name. What's your name? Call it out loud. I'm calling your name too. I'm sincere because sometimes people say, well, why do you always got to call? People get jealous. Rebuke the jealous spirit. People get jealous because I call names because that's the first thing that comes to my remembrance sometimes. And the second thing is because they won't be offended if I call their name, because some of y'all would get choked up if I called your name. Now, why? And you would miss the rest of the service. If I said, Veronica, I'm glad you made the church today. I know you partied until, what time you get in this morning? Yeah. But I'm glad you're here. Praise the Lord, you're here. Yeah. But see, now she'll pinch her mama, but she won't get mad at me. See, you can't say that to everybody. So that's why I don't call everybody's name, because some of y'all will be tripped out for the whole year. In fact, you wouldn't come back because he called my name. He embarrassed me. Trust me, I am not focusing on any individual, but the Holy Spirit is. Our theme this year for 2017, don't get it wrong, empowered. It's with an ED. We're not being empowered. You already are empowered. In Acts 1 and 8, the scripture was read this morning. He says clearly, but you will receive power. Somebody say power.
Power.
Question is, who is he talking to? Yes. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. And then you will be a witness how God can make a way out of no way. You'll be a witness of how God, Jehovah God, Jireh, will be able to open up closed doors. You'll be a witness how God will allow you to be in school and get an education and don't want to have to worry about your tuition. After the Holy Spirit, you can try, there are other spirits. I'm not ignorant of that. Because the Bible understands, William, that there are other spirits, and that's why he gives us the authority. He says, try the Spirit by the Spirit and see the Spirit of truth. See, I am confident enough in the Holy Spirit that when the Holy Spirit says something to us, to his church, we can guarantee that it shall come to pass if we accommodate what the Holy Spirit says to do. Now, you can't just do what you want to do and say what you want to say and not believe what you don't want to believe and then expect the Holy Spirit, well, do it, Holy Spirit, you said you were going to do it. After you receive the Holy Spirit, there are some things that you have to do. You have to believe that he is. Amen, somebody. And you have to believe that the promise is going to be fulfilled in you. See, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. Somebody say Holy Spirit. Because there are other spirits in the house. There are other spirits that are trying to tell you that I don't believe in the Holy Spirit. You ain't got to believe in the Holy Spirit for me. You got to believe it for yourself. And I'll tell you anytime, I'll put the Holy Spirit against any spirit you're trying to affirm any day, any time, any moment, any hour. Because he's just that real. Now you can't test him. You can't try him. You can't do anything but prove him. And he said, prove me and see if I won't do what I said I would do. I said you all have been empowered. See, learning to be empowered is going through the process. I believe God has said that we have already gone through so much that he's already empowered you. You've got enough Bible study in you right now if you come. You've got enough Bible study in you, enough Sunday school lesson in you to last you for the rest of your life if you don't ever pick up your Bible. If you can believe what the Holy Spirit has already said to the church. Now, that does not give you right or give you reason not to come. Because just like you get one fill up when you got your first car, you haven't not filled it up since then. If I only needed one fill. You have to keep on getting filled. We don't come out of tradition on Sunday. Check it out. We come so we can get refilled. But in order to get refilled, you know, we don't have self-serving gas stations any longer. You've got to get out of your own car. Whether it's raining, whether it's snowing, whether it's hot, whether it's cold, you've got to get out of your own car. Open up your own tank hood. Amen. Go in and pay first or put your debit card in and you've got to pump. Some of you are so waiting for God just to come by and give you a drive-by blessing. You don't want to have to do anything for it. You don't want to have to serve him. You don't want to have to obey him. You don't want to have to give unto him. You don't want to have to do anything but get the blessing. And that's why some people hang around blessed folks so they can get the overflow. But I'm here to tell somebody, this year you're going to have to walk on your own. The Spirit helped the church after they were empowered, after the Holy Spirit had came upon them. And the Spirit helped a shepherd boy. So don't tell me what the Spirit of God won't do. He helped a shepherd boy to become a king. He helped a fisherman to become disciples. The Holy Spirit helped a murderer in Egypt to become a deliverer of a slave nation. And he helped a carpenter to become the Messiah. the Son of the living God. You see, when we look at our tasks that God has placed on us, these are God assignments. You've got to be mindful and be careful that you are not walking into someone else's assignment, but you're living and walking in God's assignment in 2017. God has allowed us to live not because we've been so good and not because we've been so bad, but God has allowed us to live because God has an assignment for us to fulfill. You've been empowered to fulfill your 2017 assignment. And because you've been empowered by the Holy Spirit, everything you need to complete the assignment you already have in you, if you would allow it to activate itself. You don't have to ask for it, but God help me. No, you shall receive what?
Power.
Y'all weak on that power. You shall receive what?
Power.
After the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And see, that would be the condition then. Are you living and walking under the Holy Spirit? Or have you allowed the Holy Spirit to be dormant in your life? When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, He gives you the Holy Spirit. It's a Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Father has his authority. The Father has given authority in the name of Jesus. And then the Father has given the Holy Spirit so that you can always know that His presence is with us. But if we don't use the order that God has given to us when we ask anything according to His will, yeah, He said you can ask anything, but it has to be according to His will. And if you don't know the will, then you can't ask according to His will. Some folks say, well, God said I can ask anything. That is not the truth. He did not say you can ask anything. It has to be according to His will. And in order to know His will, the Holy Spirit has got to be activating in your life, because some of us want our will. Put the tithing down. Stop looking at the pictures. Put the tithing down. Listen to the word. Some people want your will to be God's will. God's will is not going to be our will. You want God's will. And that's why some of us are so frustrated, because you want God's will to turn into your will. But no, you really want the will of God. The safest place to be in the whole wide world is in the will of God. I said the safest place. It's not a common place. It's not a good place. Sometimes it's a lonely place. Sometimes it's a scary place. But the safest place, hello somebody, to be is the will of God. I'd rather be in the will of God than to be in good company. Hello somebody. So prayerfully consider that God's task for 2017, it needs to be God's task. You don't do it because you, and I told Reverend Person this morning, we were having a little conversation this morning, that sometimes when people humanly are empowered, when people are humanly empowered, they think they are entitled. Hello somebody, I'm preaching to the choir right now. I said sometimes when people are empowered as humans, they think they are entitled. Well, this is what I, don't you touch those flowers on here. These are my flowers. Who moved my flowers? I did. Because they've been in the same place every day, so I want something to look different.
Come on, Pastor.
Well, that's what we do. No, today that's what.
Come on.
Y'all laughing. I'm not laughing. See, when you know that you've been empowered, you don't have to ask, wait, can I? May I? And so many times locally, even at your cubicle at school, your little workplace at work and all that, you think that's your, that don't belong to you. You got your pictures all up here and your mugs all over here and got, you know, do not disturb signs. That ain't none of yours. That's your workplace. And when somebody else come in, they may change it. But when you know that the Holy Spirit is control, you're not intimidated. Because if you, when I moved over here, I gave my old desk to Reverend Person. And he didn't like it, so he passed it on to Minister Howe. Now, I gave the old desk to Reverend Person intentionally. Because the old desk didn't have no drawers. And I didn't want him to have no drawers. Because I didn't want him to store anything in the drawers. I didn't want him to hide nothing in the drawers, like candy and potato chips and popcorn. So I said, well, this good thing. So then the next thing I know, I'm walking around. I'm like, well, how did Minister Howe? But what happened is he understood that there was some empowerment in him. But then when the pastor who's empowered asked about it, then he said, may I? Hello, somebody. What I'm talking about, you all, when you know how empowered and where empowered comes from, you have to always go back to the source. I'm just using this as a human demonstration. But spiritually, when you know that you've been empowered by God, I ain't got to go to you and ask you how to pray. I don't have to go to ask you if I can sing. I don't have to go to you and ask you if I can usher. I don't have to go to ask you if I can serve. I've been empowered. Now, some people will look at that humanly and say that you are cocky and self-centered. No, you've got to be confident, because the world that we're living in, the enemy is trying to steal everything God has given you. And God has given us the mindset to live. He said, not by power nor by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. So it's not by our power. It's not by my title. It doesn't matter. I don't have an office in this place. I have a room that I operate out of. And I am well aware of that, because I realize that sitting behind the desk don't give you empowerment. It's what you do behind and in front of the desk. And, oh no, no, no! Having a robe on does not give you the entitlement. Serving and visiting and praying and loving and forgiving and preaching in season and out season. See, this, no. This is just a celebration of what has been happening all week long. Don't get it wrong, somebody. So when you look at your own lives today, don't you get it wrong. You're not going to be what your situation have been. In fact, you don't even look like what you've been through. Well, what you mean, Pastor? That's a song. Yeah, it is. And the reason why they wrote that song is because the blood still works. Y'all better thank God for the blood. And I ain't talking about the blood that was shed on the streets of Chicago in the years of 2016. I'm talking about the blood of Christ that has been shed 2,000 years ago. That blood still works. So as we think about our 2017 theme, we begin this 2000 year with that kind of power, that kind of assurance. Oh my God, how are you going to build another place in the community, Pastor? Been empowered. As of next Sunday, the ropes are coming down on either side. Why? Because we're getting ready for the overflow. How is it going to happen, Pastor? Because we've been empowered. Amen. Extra chairs at Bible class, morning and evening. Amen. Dottie, where's Dottie at? Stand up. Stand up. Hurry up. Stand up. Don't put your head down. Heave it up. Last night she testifying in service. I went home with that last night, Dottie. How God had, she was living in a situation that was unlivable, if you would. Bad environment. Bad situation. From heat to walls, etc. Just bad all the way around. She had been praying that God would bless her with a new place. So she prayed. She was empowered. Then her daughter suggested, Mom, let's go look for some new furniture.
Yes, God.
Dot said, well, how are we going to get some new furniture? I ain't got no credit.
Yes, sir.
Furthermore, we don't have no place to move. How many of you know that God's design?
Yes,
God's order don't work like your order.
You've got to get it this right, got to get the money in the bank right, you got to get your down payment. How many of you know that when God is in the plan, sometimes God will shift all of that around just to show you it's me and not you. Hold it. So Dottie went to the furniture store with her daughter. You got to have somebody who believes. Don't take nobody anywhere with you who don't have no faith for themselves. Don't take nobody shopping with you, praying with you, I'm believing God for a new car, and they sit up there, well, you don't need this kind of car. You don't need this car. Are you with me? You got to take somebody with you who see beyond you. If you had not been there over 20 some years, I wouldn't be driving what I'm driving right now. I didn't like cars. Dottie and her daughter went and bought the furniture. But number one, she got favor from God because the credit did what? That was enough to testify and shout about right there. I'm talking to somebody right now. Don't get stuck. I'm getting ready to get to you. But sometimes, let me show you something. This is side. No, this is for free. Stand, doctor, don't sit down. So, side note. See, sometimes people say, well, I don't know how. Come on in, Sherry. You right on time. Yeah, I'm glad you made it. You obedient. Mm-hmm. But you just came in. But you made it, baby. I see you changed your blouse from last night, but you made it. Come on down to the front. Yeah, right. Come on down to the front. That's it. Yeah, you made it. Mm-hmm. Hello, everybody. Hello. But she went to, the first thing is, talking about your mom. The first, no, not your mom, your aunt. The first thing is, you got the credit approved. Boom. But that's because you've been obedient. And she said it last night. I obeyed. I've been paying my tithes. When I wanted to keep my money, because I needed the money to pay my rent, but I paid my tithes. You see, you can't trust God when you trust in the landlord. You are more scared of the landlord than you are God. Hello, somebody. Well, I got to keep a roof over my head. Who do you think will help keep a roof over your head? The landlord will change on you in a minute. You better make sure that God is the one who you in right with. So she paid the tithes. She gave her offering. She created these banners. Gave her offerings. Mm-hmm. That's what true Christians are supposed to do. You ain't get paid for everything. You get to give something. Hold it. So they went and bought the furniture. Ain't that something? Then she got back to the house. All y'all coming in. Come on down to the front. Come on. All the way down. Move over, William. All the way down. That's all right, baby. I'm glad you're here. You made it. Come on in. You right in the middle of my sermon. You know I love you. I told them I don't care what time, come to church. Now, if I say that and they do it, I can't believe they walked in. And you here, you ain't worship yet. Yeah. So anywho, let me get back to the story because I know y'all tripping because I'm so real. And see, and I'm not apologizing. One time in 2017, I've been empowered. I'm trying to get an intergenerational congregation that will come in here and walls will be jam-packed. I'm tired of preaching to, yeah. Y'all getting all obese and fat and ain't doing nothing, exercising, faith ain't growing. No. We gonna grow. I don't want to see no more empty pews. I want to see some empty streets. Hello, somebody. So, okay, talk. Stand up, Dottie. Don't sit down. So she went and got her furniture, and she said last night, "It's some good furniture. It's some nice furniture." Well, if God tells you to do it, He only gives us. But then she got back home and, you know how the enemy, after you do what God say do, then the enemy start working your mind. Then she got back home like, why did I let her talk me into buying that furniture and we ain't even got nowhere to live? You see, that's our way of doing it. But we walk by faith and not
by sight. Thank you, God.
And then he says, now faith is the substance of things, and it is the
evidence
of things
not seen.
So God said, you want a new apartment? You've got to prepare for the new apartment. You've got to, and so you got mad when folks start breaking up your old furniture. And you got mad. But see, again, it was a setup. Your attitude, you were kind of disappointed, but your attitude was right. See, God will see if you can handle the increase. Some folk ain't getting the increase because you can't be thankful for what you already have. You trying to get something more and you won't even praise God. You won't even use God. When you didn't have a job, God, I don't have no money and I'm no job, but I can do that.
That's it.
I can offer something. And some of us, we waiting, but when I get my money, I'm gonna show y'all. No, you ain't gotta show me nothing. I'm gonna pay this church off. No, you will not pay this church off. God did not intend for any individual to pay this church off because it's not your church. God intended for the people of God to come together in unity and in love to pay off the building. That's what God has intended, and that's God's will. So God ain't gonna give you the lottery ticket, because if that was the case, he would have given me the numbers years ago. I didn't ask him. Oh, y'all can go deep if you want to. I did. However you want to bless me, God, I'll take it. And if you had blessed me with a meal, I would have been, yeah. But that wasn't God's will, and it's not God's will. God said, I'm going to do it my way. And that's why he's going to pay off this mortgage in 3.5 years. I know that a lot of people don't believe it because you're looking for the plan. God has already given the plan and the affirmation. Stand up, Dottie. Got the furniture. Got back home. It was only until she started celebrating the furniture. She asked God for a 3-bedroom apartment. He said, I'll open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. Hello, somebody.
Yes.
3-bedroom, but what do you have now?
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Well, Pastor, why did you use her as an example? You can sit down now. When you walk as an empowered believer, it's not just for church. It's for every element of your lives. Your bank accounts will change. Your physical conditions because of your mindset. Are you with me? You've got, even young people in school, you've got to be empowered by faith to know that I am different. But it ain't because of the neighborhood I came from. It's because of the God who created me. I am on full scholarship. It's not because of my mother's and my father's intent. It's because of God's favor in my life. You've got to know that the empowerment is not just for you, but it's for every piece of your household. It's for everything you touch. God said, if you touch it, I'll bless it. I've got to close. I can't. It's going to be serious with this. But let me close with this statement. You can't be empowered without first having trust. You've got to trust the one who empowers you. And you've got to trust the full promise that he gives to you. Stop diluting God's promise when you are walking in his will. I'll say it again. Stop diluting God's promise when you're walking in his will. Now, I'm a tither, and I believe that that is God's way of us keeping our covenant. when you're wishy-washy with that, because again, he decided to use this way. I wish you could study Malachi, not me. And I don't mind talking about it or preaching or teaching about it, because that's his way of deliverance. When you are wishy-washy with your commitment unto God, not only with tithe, but with time and your talents, then God can entrust you with his power. Because then you will abuse his power. Yeah. If you don't trust God who empowers you, so you've got to trust him with all that you have. And it's a process, but you've got to be on the process. And then when you trust him with all that he has given you, the empowerment that he's given you, and now you know that you are empowered, God can trust the vehicle that he has empowered. And he knows you will not abuse it. Preachers, pastors, I'm not leaving us out. People can abuse the authority. But God gives us authority, and it has to be according to the scripture. But if you don't know the authority, you think somebody, well, he can't tell me what to do. He's a man like I am, and he puts his pants on like I do, and da 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 da. You know how they say, and people have said that. People always say that's the human piece. He can't tell me what to do. He's just a preacher. He ain't up with a preacher, and he ain't up with no. He always talking about money. He always talking about money. That's why I don't come, because I be feeling bad. I ain't no money. The reason why you ain't got no money, because you don't want to give what you do have. Don't be using that as an excuse. Your dentist asks you to pay their bill and you don't complain. When you go to the grocery line, do you say, well, you know what? I can't believe it. I got to pay all this money for these groceries. Do you put it back? The Christmas outfits you bought, did you complain? Don't you dare talk about, yeah, I just tell him. I am, because somebody got to pay the line. God gives us the authority, because if, hey, if you don't have no job, he still gives you the ability to do something. Stop being all whining all the time. It's past. Ain't nobody taking your whininess in 2017. You ain't the only one who got a baby. You ain't the only one who divorced. You ain't the only one who's a widow or a widower. You ain't the only one. You've got to be faithful. Stop building our treasures up in here. And that's why when you come here, you feel all guilty. And that's not me. I ain't trying to make nobody feel bad. I'm trying to give you life. I'm trying to give you hope. I'm trying to get you delivered. I want everybody to be debt free. I ain't just talking about money. I'm talking about our attitude. But I ask God. And the reason why I'm telling you, to my personal testimony, the reason why I am blessed because of my obedience. It ain't because of where I'm working. Don't get it wrong. It's because of God. Yeah. Something be wrong. If I'm up here preaching and teaching, and ain't ever got no money in my pocket. Something be wrong, William, if I gotta ask you for a ride and can I borrow $2 from you? I do expect. Yeah. I don't deposit nothing I don't expect a return from. So I am. That's gonna be a driver for me. When I get older, come home and drive for me on the weekend. That's why I'm asking God for it. I want a driver. But anyway, that ain't gonna do. But see, y'all think so low. Not y'all. I mean, in general, people think so low that when people think like that, people look at people and they say, you know, but the rappers can blame. You know, y'all ain't talking about Usher's house. Y'all ain't complaining that he got 3 houses and 2 jets. Y'all ain't talking about this person. You know, they can blame. And then the man of God, the woman of God, who's preaching faith, y'all don't want him to have nothing. You want me to be poor like you poor? I am not going to be poor. And I'm not talking about material things. But I'm not going to be poor in spirit, and I'm not going to be poor in flesh. No, I'm not. No, I. No, 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 now you might as well know right now in advance. So you might as well get out my way. And you, if you're gonna be, if you thin-skinned and all that, and well, then you know, keep it moving, keep it moving, keep it moving. So I got to close because I'm starting to melon. And my uncle said you didn't stop preaching. Now he went to melon. My uncle Joseph will say that in a minute. Stop, because you didn't start melon and he stopped preaching. You cannot be empowered without first having trust. And if you don't trust, as an example, the people you're working with, then you will lose control of the empowerment. You see, God does trust us. And the reason why God can trust us, because he has an investment in us. He put Jesus in us. So he really, what he's trusting is who is in us. Because he knows what he tells his son to do through us and in us shall come to pass. Y'all might as well get light and put a smile on your face. Because you've been. It is so. The first part of our 2017 preaching series. And the Church of God said amen. Say amen again. Those of you who can stand for a moment. There may be someone in this sanctuary who said, Pastor, I need that kind of experience. The only way you can get it is through accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. If there's a person in this room right now and you have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, may I extend an invitation for you to make that commitment on today. And if you already believe it, you say, Pastor, I would like to join this faith community. The doors of the church are open for you, you, and even you. Is there anybody? The doors of the church are open. We extend our hands, our hearts, and opens up to you.
Jesus lifted me.
Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me. I'm singing glory. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'm so glad.
Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad. Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad. Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah.
Let us prepare ourselves for our benevolent offering. If you came in right after the offering was taken, you may place your tithes and offerings in this basket. This benevolent is for the outreach and support of the inner ministries of our church. We ask you, if you can, to share something. If you don't share, have anything to share, it's okay. Just share your love and your peace as you prepare for the Lord's table. Ushers may come. Ooh.